I don't blame you if you don't believe the story I'm about to tell you, because I hardly believe it myself. My name's Alyssa, and I'm your Orthodox Jewish non-Rev mom friend. If you've been following our saga, we were in New Jersey for a wedding, and we've been trying to get home, flying out of Philadelphia since Sunday at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it is now Monday at 10:45 Central Time, 11:45. So almost 24 hours now. I could go back to all my recent videos to watch the entire story, but we woke up in St. Louis this morning. We were so close to going home. We made the connection. We were standing in line to board. We were cleared for the flight, and then they canceled it. The crew had timed out. There was terrible weather in Chicago. So someone at the gate told my husband to book at the Crown Plaza. So he did. We got the last room. There were two rooms left, and we got one of them. The shuttle is supposed to come every 10 to 15 minutes to bring you to the hotel from the airport, and we stood there for 45 minutes and we called and called and called and nobody was answering. So we stood there till like 1:45 in the morning with two very tired kids, and I was at the end of my rope also, and we finally just took an Uber to the hotel. Lots of flights have been canceled because of weather, so my husband then stood in another 45 minute line with one poor hotel worker trying to check everybody in. I failed to mention that our bags had also been gate checked in Philadelphia to St. Louis, so we didn't have our bags because they were taking so long to unload them off the plane. So we finally get up to the room at like 2:30 in the morning. We are disgusting. The Philadelphia airport is disgusting. I'm sorry, it's gross. It was hot in there, it was stinky. Like, I was like, we have to shower, but we had no clean clothes. So we all showered and put back on dirty clothes. We like flipped our underwear inside out and then went to sleep. The hotel room was gross. There was hair on the floor of the bathroom that did not belong to us. There were weird substances on the shower curtain. It was like 4 a.m. by that point, and we just didn't care. Sometime very, very early this morning, my husband went back to the airport and finally got our bags. So we were able to like put on clean clothes this morning, because I always pack extra clothes because moms always pack extra clothes. We also keep kosher and hadn't had real food in like almost 24 hours. Like, we were thriving on snacks and cheese sticks. So this morning I finally went and was able to like get kosher food for our family. The kids are now swimming at the hotel pool. We are going to the airport to try and get on an appears to be very open flight at 2:30, and if we can't get on it, we are gonna drive home. This is the downside of non-Rev travel. My kids are really handling it like total champions. I might be the one who's not handling it so well.